Dill versus the Secretary of State for Housing, Communities and Local Government and another. Final judgment of the Supreme Court. This appeal arises under the listed buildings legislation. It concerns a pair of important early 18th century lead urns resting on limestone pedestals. They were originally commissioned for a historic garden at Rest Park in Bedfordshire, where they remained until 1939. But they were moved a number of times since then. In 1973, they were moved by the appellant's father to the garden of Idlicote House in the Cotswolds. In June 1986, the urns and their plinths were included in the statutory list of listed buildings. In 1993, the appellant acquired the house with the vases, but he was not aware of their listing. In 2009, he sold them at auction. In 2015, the local authorities started enforcement proceedings requiring their reinstatement. The appellant appealed to the Secretary of State, arguing that they were not buildings under the relevant statute and should not have been included in the list. In January 2017, the appeals were dismissed by the planning inspector, who held that the status of the items as buildings was established by the listing and was not open for consideration on appeal. That view was upheld by the High Court and the Court of Appeal. The Supreme Court now unanimously allows the appeal in a judgment given by myself. It is a principle that individuals affected by a legal measure should have a fair opportunity to challenge the measure and to vindicate their rights in court proceedings. There is nothing in this statute to exclude or limit that right. Under the statutory scheme, a listed building means, quote, a building which is included in the list, close quote. Therefore, it is an essential element that the thing in issue be a building. It is not in truth a building at all. There is nothing in the statute to say that the mere inclusion in the list will make it otherwise. The statutory grounds of appeal are wide enough to enable that issue to be considered by a planning inspector. No different in principle from similar issues which may arise in planning appeals, and is more appropriate for determination in that way than by judicial review. The enforcement appeal must accordingly be remitted to the Secretary of State. Although it is not now for the court to determine whether the vases were properly included in the list, the appeal has disclosed a need for further consideration by the Secretary of State and guidance on the treatment of such items under the listed building legislation and the legal principles in play. In the planning context, the Court of Appeal, in a case called Skerritts of Nottingham, has approved a threefold test for deciding what is a building, that is, size, permanence, and degree of physical attachment. The same statutory definition has been applied in the listed building legislation, but the previous cases have been concerned with very different factual contexts. The application of this test to the vases in the present case is a matter to be considered in the context of the remittal of the appeal to the Secretary.